Hi, this is Holly with Presence Point, and Doug and I are hiking in the eastern Sierra Nevada mountains in central California, just outside of a little teeny town called Independence. And we came around a corner this morning and saw what you see around me, just vast amounts of stone. Clearly at some point there was a rock slide that just, I mean, I can't imagine the size of it or the length of it or the sound of it. But as I saw these, they're about 200 yards wide, probably a half a mile to three quarters mile long from where it starts above me to down below this makeshift road run. But I'm a visual person. When I see something, sometimes it just reminds me of something so profoundly that I just have to stop. And we came around a corner, a little bend in this sort of road, and I just stopped and said, "Look, Doug, look at this." In the middle of where there was sagebrush and trees and probably wildlife, we have just acres and acres of stones. These are probably about 3 foot high, the ones below us maybe 2 foot deep. I mean, it's just so much stone. And I immediately thought of Jesus. I thought, you know, in Matthew, in the Gospels, several places, we know about his temptation. We learn about that temptation. So here's this young man, 33-ish years of age. John the Baptist comes ahead of us, comes ahead of him toward the end of Matthew 3 saying, you know, "I'm a voice crying in the wilderness, the Messiah is coming." And then of course he finds himself baptizing Jesus after he even was reluctant to do so. But then we get to Matthew 4, to the temptation of Jesus. Verse 1, "Then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted there by the devil. For 40 days and 40 nights he fasted and became very hungry. During that time the devil came and said to him, 'If you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become loaves of bread.'" I'm going to stop there because I've said many times, man, you have me fast for 2 days and I'd be turning these stones to bread if I could, right? So little, I don't know, so little ability, right, to resist temptation. But the reality is, our Savior was because this God-man who had the ability to sin. He chose not to, but he had the ability to sin. Satan wouldn't have bothered tempting him if he didn't. And I love what Jesus said. But Jesus told him, "No." And I love in Scripture when you see an exclamation point, which isn't all that often, but no. The Scriptures say, "People do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God." You know, someone just said to me recently that we need visuals to show us, you know, abstracts. We need visuals to show us concepts. So, for example, the beautiful visual that God gives us in Scripture for leadership all throughout the Word of God is shepherd and shepherding. And he gives this also visual of us humans, us followers, as sheep. But today when I turned this corner, I was like, oh my goodness, look at all of this bread, all of these stones to bread. And Jesus says, he gives us the visual. "Please do not live, people do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes out of the mouth of God." I don't have my Bible with me at the moment, but I want to say this, if I had it in my hand, you've seen it in these blogs, this is the bread of life. This is what we're supposed to live on. This is what gives us nourishment. Right now it's in my iPhone, but that is what gives us nourishment. Then the devil took Jesus to the top of the temple, you know, and says, "Jump off if you're the Son of God," because it says, meaning the Scriptures, the Torah says, you know, that he's going to guard his angels to watch you. Jesus says, the Scriptures also say, "You must not tempt or test the Lord your God." Next, the devil took him to the peak of a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their glory. "I will give it all to you," he said, "if you will kneel down and worship me." And this is when I really love our Savior's response. This version says, "Get out of here, Satan. I'm done with you," is what he's really saying. Get out of here. Be gone. And that is what we have to do. The enemy does that until he waits for another time to tempt Jesus because he knows there'll be more. But what I love about this is Jesus gives us first the visual that all of these stones could be bread when we're starving hungry, but even better is the bread of life, his word. Everything we need is in it, everything. And then I love the beautiful example he gives us where he says, just get out of here. Just get out of here. I've said it out loud to the enemy myself from time to time. Just stop. I'm done with you. Stop. As shepherd leaders, as shepherd moms and dads, and as shepherd pastors, and as shepherd supervisors and managers and shepherd friends when we're leading laterally with those around us, as kids in high schools, as kids in youth groups, as shepherds, we are influencers and we impact those around us. We have to be able to say, this, not my iPhone, but the bread of life I have within it in an app, is what I rely on. And we have to be able to say to the enemy, no, exclamation point, get out of here. So my encouragement to you this week is when the temptation comes, because you know it will. It might be in 5 minutes or 5 hours, but you know it will. Please stand tall and exclaim no. Stand tall and say, get out, because I have the Holy Spirit within me. I have the superpower within me of my God, who keeps me from doing the things that you want me to do, Mr. Enemy. Be encouraged today. Be blessed to live deeply into your calling. Whatever the temptation is for you, run from it. Tell the enemy to get lost, because the body of Christ needs you to shepherd them well. May you live deeply into your calling. Thanks for joining us.